Okay, students, a very good morning. I'm starting to share my screen. Okay, so as I told you, we have completed SNMP version 1 and version 2. And today we will be starting SNMP version 3. So in SNMP version 3 also we will be looking about the SMI and MIB, and as I told you earlier, security feature is the important point that is enhanced in SNMP version 3. So these three things are to be looked on in version 3. And before we start MIB and SMI, so that this year structure of management information, we will be looking about what is the different thing that we have in version 3 that is not available in version 1 and version 2, and then we'll be looking about the architecture and what are the different applications that are available as per it is given in your version 3 architecture. So this is it for today. So we'll begin. So these are the key function features that SNMP version 3 provides. So it modularizes the architecture and documentation. So the documentation meaning that is your RFC, right? So request for comments. So we have this RFC so that we can know anything and everything about the SNMP. So this will give you an idea how different things are happening in SNMP. So be it version 1 or version 2 or version 3. So we have an organized way of representing how the things happen. So that is one features that we have in version 3. And the second one that we will have is your SNMP engine. Okay, so this SNMP engine is able to dispatch the messages that it receives. Meaning we have 7 messages, right? Get request, get next request, get bulk request, set response, inform request, trap, all these 7 messages through which your manager and your agent will communicate. So with this message, so we need someone who will be able to dispatch. Okay, when we post something in the post through a post box, we have a dispatching unit, which is your post office. So your post office will collect all the mails, that is your envelopes that you post, and it will be dispatched to the corresponding locations. So if you are sending a post which has to be reached at Delhi, then it is dispatched in a way such that the parcel or the envelope is reached on time. So that is a thing that a dispatcher does, same thing. So this will dispatch the messages according to what it is to be done. So if it is a get request, so which agent it has to respond. So that get request message will be dispatched to the particular agent. So we have group of agents, right? We have many agents which are managed by the manager. So this dispatcher will be able to dispatch the messages to the particular agent. So this is done with the help of a message processor model, MPM. Okay, so this message processor model will help the dispatcher to dispatch the messages to the corresponding agent. So this is one of the features that is added in version 3. So this is capable of working in all the 3 versions. So this is introduced in version 3 and it is capable of working in version 1, version 2 and version 3 as well. And as I told you, security is the important feature in version 3. So we will have to securely send the request and we'll have to get the response through the manager and agent in your network. So we do it so that the messages are not getting tampered and the response is not getting tampered by any third party. And then we should also provide authentication. Okay, if a manager doesn't have rights to do a particular request, then it shouldn't be doing it. So that is done with the security feature which is available, which is enhanced in version 3. In version 2 also we have security, but it is enhanced in version 3. So authentication and security of the messages that it is transferred through the network, so that is to be taken care of. So we shouldn't have any tampering or any third party who enters into the network and does all kinds of unnecessary things. So that is done by the security feature. So that is done so that it doesn't happen. So, and also the data that we transfer is also encrypted. So we have different encryption techniques. So encryption techniques are nothing but we change the pattern in which you send your data. So if I send a data, hi, hello, then it is encrypted such that it is received at the receiver end, only it is in a normal message. So through the network, it is encrypted. So it is encrypted to a format such that others will not be able to view it. So your WhatsApp does the end-to-end encryption. So even WhatsApp will not be able to view your messages. That's what the notification WhatsApp gives you. So all your messages are end-to-end encrypted in WhatsApp. So that provides the security feature. So likewise in SNMP version 3, so we have the security feature which enhances the feature which is available in version 2. So it provides more security by providing an encryption to all the messages that are transferred, messages or information that the manager and the agent takes to communicate with each other. So these were the features that were added on in version 3. That is, you had the engine, SNMP engine, and then we had the security feature. And this is the architecture that we are going to look upon. So this architecture, so we have these components. Okay, so these are the different elements that are available in version 3. So these are every individual component we'll be looking about today. So that is what is the application that I told you, right? So you have this application which is mentioned here. So this application is not like you are going to say what are the applications of SNMP. So these applications are using the features of SNMP to work in a better manner. So that is what these applications are. So this SNMP version 3 architecture, it consists of SNMP entity, and this SNMP entity contains SNMP engine and application. So this SNMP engine is identified by using an identifier, object identifier, which is nothing but SNMP engine ID. So this SNMP engine ID will be able to uniquely identify what that SNMP engine is. So this engine helps us to make the dispatching of the messages done in a proper manner. It helps us to provide the security feature, and it helps us to provide the access control. So these are the things that we have in SNMP engine. So this is what we studied as the feature of SNMP version 3. So that is, it was able to dispatch the messages, and it was able to provide security, and it was able to provide access control. So how this is happening? So we'll be looking about each of the component separately. So next is the application. So these are the different applications through on which work on your SNMP. So command generator. So this command generator is used to process or send the request, like get message, get next message, get bulk messages. So we are sending some kind of request from the manager, right? So that is done by the command generator. And command responder is nothing but the response that you get from the agent for whichever message that has been given by the manager. So command generator is nothing but providing the request, and the command responder is providing the response from the agent to the manager. So next one is notification receiver and notification originator. So this command generator and receiver are only for the messages like which are coming up from the manager. So manager only will give you the get request, get next request, get bulk request, inform request, all those things. the kind of message that your agent will give is only notification. That is your trap message. So this kind of messages which the agent sends, okay, agent sends messages, right? So that is given by your notification originator and receiver. So this notification receiver and originator was used for the notification messages that your agent sends to the manager. And next is the proxy forwarder subsystem. So this proxy for we have already seen earlier, right? So this proxy was capable of working, that is, it was able to give you the comfort that every component that was capable of running in version 1 and version 2 were able to run on version 3 with the help of the proxy server. So if you could remember in the last class, I gave a diagram. If the messages are what is capable of executing in version 1, version 2, and version 3, if it is compatible with all the versions, then what they do is they just pass through the message. That is, the message just goes through the proxy server into the manager or into the agent. If the message is something which is enhanced in version 3, so then what is the enhancement that is done in version 3? That is appended and it passes through the proxy server. So proxy server will append it. So if you could remember, we saw the PDU of get bulk, that protocol data unit, that is the structure in which your get bulk message is getting passed. So we have that a set maximum number of repetitions that will happen, and we were able to set what is the number of parameters which are non-repeated. So these two parameters are added, right? So if these parameters are added, then it becomes a normal get next message, get next request message. So if you add these two components onto a get next request message, then it becomes a get bulk request message. So these two things are added by the proxy server. So likewise, if we have a trap, okay, if I want to set a parameter, then I set it and then it becomes a trap message which is compatible in all the versions. So that is the work of a proxy server. Next, other is any other kind of applications that we might have that works with the SNMP. So we will be looking about each of the component now. So this is what's the topic for today, the architecture and the different applications. So first is your SNMP engine. So as I told you, SNMP engine is identified by object identifier, which is SNMP engine ID. So SNMP engine ID is the object identifier that we provide for the SNMP engine. So what this SNMP engine comprises? So it consists of the dispatcher, message processing subsystem, and the security subsystem, and the access control subsystem. So as we saw this diagram, right? So we have this dispatcher, message processing subsystem, security subsystem, and access control subsystem. So what is the work of these things that we will look on? So before we going into that, so as I told you, SNMP engine ID is an object identifier, right? So you need some kind of representation to represent the ID. So this, as I told you, the engine is capable of working with all the three versions of SNMP. In version 1 and version 2, it was a fixed length size, which is 12 octets, okay, which means 12 into 8. That was the length in bits. So 12 octet is the length of the system SNMP engine ID. And in version 3, the length was a variable length. So this is given in this picture. So this is the SNMP engine ID. And this is your first version 1 and version 2. And this is version 3. So in version 1 and version 2, the size was 12 octet. So as you can see here, it is 12. So maximum it is 12 octets, and these are splitted into four parts. So first bit will be set to 0 if it is version 1 and version 2, and it will be set to 1 if it is version 3. Okay, so to differentiate between the different versions, the first bit is set to 0 if it is version 1 and 2, and it is set to 1 if it is version 3. And next is enterprise ID. So enterprise ID is a unique ID that is the enterprise ID uses. For example, what is its value? So that is given as the 5th octet. So that you can look here. So it is 0 if it is reserved, and it is 1 if it is IP version 4, and it is 2 if it is IP version 6, and if it is a MAC, it is 3, and so on. So these are the enterprise methods. So depending on the enterprise method, this 5th octet is set. So next is the function of the method. So this enterprise method works on which function? So that function is represented in the 6 to 12 octets. That is the last 6 octets. And it is the same in version 3. So we have this enterprise ID and then format indicator, which is same like your enterprise method. So here the format is of variable octets. So here the function, it is of fixed length, it is 6 octets, but here it is variable. So that is the difference that we have in version 1, 2 and with version 3. So this is important. So first bit, if it is set to 0, it indicates that it is version 1 and 2, and if it is set to 1, it indicates that it is version 3. So this is the and then in version 1 and 2, the SNMP engine ID is 12 octets, it is fixed, and in version 3 it is variable length. So next is about the dispatch subsystem. So what this dispatch subsystem will do? So as I told you, it will dispatch the messages to the corresponding agent or to the corresponding manager. So these are the three main functionalities that your dispatcher will do. So first, it will send message and receive message from the network. So it will send message to the manager or receive message from the manager or into the agent. So both is possible. So it is used to communicate between your manager and your agent. So second, it determines the version of the message and interacts with the corresponding MPM. So this is your message processor module. So this message processor module will be able to do the dispatch. So which version? So you have 7 messages, right? So version 1, what are the messages we have, and version 2 you are familiar with. So these versions, so depending on the versions of the SNMP, then it processes the messages with the help of MPM. MPM is message processor module. So if the message processor module that could not identify what that message is, then your dispatcher will discard the message. Okay, if the message is not compatible with SNMP version, all the three versions, okay, if you do any kind of a mistake by generating the wrong message, then that is discarded by the dispatcher. So third one, it provides an abstract interface. So we will see what this abstract interface is. So like how we have interfaces in Java, right? So in Java, we have interface. So what's the use of interfaces? We will have methods. So those methods can be implemented by the child classes. So whatever methods we have, so these methods of the interface can be inherited or it can be implemented by the child class. So that is your abstract interface, right? So same kind of thing, we can have methods which can be accessed by the other components in the network. So that is done by the dispatcher. So these are the three main functions that your dispatcher will do. So main, it is used to send and receive messages. So it just transfers the messages through the network. And second one, it dispatches the messages depending on which kind of message it is receiving. If it is receiving a non-SNMP message, then it will be discarded. And third one, it provides abstract interface. I'll show you what is that abstract interface in the upcoming slides. And next, this dispatcher has got three components that helps it to do the work of the dispatching. So first one is transport mapper and a message dispatcher and a PDU dispatcher. So this transport mapper will will be able to send the data or the information through the network protocol. Okay, so we have protocols, right? So these transport mapper is used to deliver the messages over the appropriate protocol, okay, transport protocol of the network. So if you are using UDP or if you are using TCP, mainly SNMP uses UDP. So that depending on the how it is done, it is just mapped. And second one is message dispatcher. So message dispatcher will just dispatch the messages that it receives depending on the versions of the SNMP. If the message processor model is not able to identify what kind of message it is, then it is rejected by the message dispatcher. So it would just reject if it cannot be handled by the message processing subsystem, which is nothing but your message processor module. So this is what a message dispatcher will do. And the third one is a PDU dispatcher. So PDU stands for Protocol Data Unit. So this dispatcher will able to handle traffics that are happening inside the network. Okay, so it is used to route routing of the traffic. Okay, so that is done by the PDU dispatcher. So your dispatcher, the main aim is it is to transfer the data through the network, and it will be helping in dispatching the messages to the particular agent or to the manager, and it will give you an interface. To do that dispatching, it provides three components, and that are transport mapper, message dispatcher, and PDU dispatcher. So transport mapper is used for mapping of the messages onto the appropriate protocol, and message dispatcher will just dispatch the messages, and if it could not be identified by the message processing subsystem or the message processor model, then it is just discarded by the message dispatcher. And PDU dispatcher is used for traffic routing. And this is about your dispatcher. And the next one is message processing subsystem. So as we saw earlier, so this message processing subsystem is used to transfer or dispatch the messages according to the SNMP message that it receives. So if it cannot handle the non-SNMP messages, then it is just discarded. So you can have more than one message processing model in your SNMP. So how the version is identified is the version of the SNMP messages is identified by the version field that we have in the header of the the engine, SNMP engine. So it identifies the engine with the help of the number we have. So if it is 1 and 2, it is 0. And if it is 3, it is value as 1. So with this value, the processing unit will be able to identify what kind of message it is receiving. So that's it about message processing subsystem. And second one, the last one is security and access control subsystem. So the security feature is what is much talked about in version 3. So it will provide authentication and privacy protection. So as I told you, authentication, if a manager is in a particular network, he can communicate with the agents of that particular network alone. So you will not be able to do it in the other way. So that kind of authentication. So we have seen, right, a few objects are read-only, and few objects are write read. So those kind of things, if you are trying to write something onto the agent by the manager, then that is forbidden. So that is not permitted. So that kind of authentication is given in version 3. And it provides privacy. So how it provides privacy is all the messages are end-to-end encrypted. So every message is encrypted so that the privacy of the messages is kept secured. So this access control subsystem will provide the access authorization service, like how we have a system admin, right? So that system admin has got higher access rights when compared to the other users of the system. So that is like what we have as a access control subsystem. So if you are trying to read into or write into a device which is not accessible, then that is indicated by the access control subsystem. So this subsystem is responsible for the messages that you are transferring. Yeah, so these are the different components that we had in SNMP engine. So in engine we had dispatcher, we had a message processing subsystem, and then we had security, and we had access control subsystem. So these are the four components that we have in SNMP engine. And the next one is application. So what are the different applications that we are using to run on the SNMP? So this application module comprises of these different components that we saw in this diagram, right? So these are the components that I told you: command generator, command responder, notification receiver, notification originator, proxy subsystem, and the others. So we'll be looking about each of them. So first one, before that, we need to know what is a naming of entity. So a name is given to the entity, it is given to identities, and it is given to management information. So as you know, we name every object that we have in SNMP by using an object identifier. So this naming has got two different parameters. So one is principal and the second one is security name. So what this principal will tell you is, it will give you who is requesting for the service. Okay, if I am a user, I am an end user, right? So I am an end user. If I am a system admin, so it is an admin. So who is having the access? So who is requesting for the service? And the security name is nothing but a name which is like an English representation, which it is helpful for a person to identify. So I will call myself as user 1, or I'll call myself as user 10, or I can be an admin. So these kinds of words have meaning, right? So that is what is given as security name. So it will give you who is gonna do the access, okay, who is gonna request for the access, and what is the name that we provide. So we have in whatever we are viewing right now, so in Google Meet we have access for recording, right? So as a student, you might not have access for recording. So that is the thing. So we are identified as faculty and student. So that is how you name the security feature. So you name a person. So that is your security name. So who is requesting? So I am a user. So I am not an admin. So person who is requesting. So who is requesting and who is that person? That is given by the principal and the security name. So this is how we name different entities in order to provide the security feature. Okay, and then I was telling you about the interface, right? This dispatcher provides three functionalities. One is to transfer the message between the agent and the manager, and second one, it does it does the message transfer by using your message processing subsystem. And third one, I told you that it provides an interface. So what is the interface? So it is similar to what we have in Java. So interface provides set of methods that can be implemented by the different classes that are going to implement the interface. So if you are doing something like that, then SNMP provides a subsystem which helps you to do this kind of processing. And if the interface is generic, that is, if it is not much specific, then we call that interface as abstract service interface. So this is a diagram. Okay, so we have interface. So interfaces are named like primitive, and we have in, we have out, and these are some kinds of interfaces that we have. So this is a subsystem A, and this is B, and this is C. So these are gonna interact with each other. So how they interact with some kind of, by using some interfaces. So this primitive is an interface which tells that system A and system B are gonna communicate. So that is given here, primitive A and B. So if some inputs you are gonna give, so that is indicated by using the keyword in. And A1 and A2 are the inputs that you are passing on to the system B. So next system B communicates with system C using some kind of interface. So some interface it is using on and it is communicating. So then your system B is going to give you some response because it got some input, right? So it has to process it and it gives the response in terms of variables B1 and B2. So A1, A2, B1, B2 are variables. In and out are used to indicate that it is input and primitive is an interface. So these kinds of interface, we have status information and result. If there is any error, so that is indicated by the status information. And if you have the correct output is given, then what is the result? So this is one kind of a system interface. And next one is a generalized interface for the send PDU. So PDU, that is your protocol data unit. So if you are going to use the send PDU, so this send, that is your command generator, and you have the dispatcher, and you have the message processing model. So this send PDU is a message that is given by the command generator. So it is getting dispatched. So it is dispatched with the help of the message processor model, or I can call it as message processing model. So this MPM will do the required message handling and it gives the response back. So you get the response as either the whatever is requested that you get, or you get an error indication. So this is one kind of an interface that we use for sending a message. So this send PDU is used to communicate between the, that is, it is for your command dispatcher and your command generator. So this command, this dispatcher works with the help of MPM. So this is about the interface. So now is the application. So we saw the different applications, right? Command generator, command receiver, process request, sorry, your notification processor, notification receiver, and then we had this proxy. So we have five types of applications. So these are described in RFC 2273. So as I told you, just show the diagram again. So these are the five applications that we are going to see: command generator, command responder, notification receiver, notification originator, and the proxy forwarder subsystem. So this is your command generator. So as I told you, this command generator is used to process or generate all the messages that is coming from your manager. So the messages that comes from the manager are get request, get next request, get bulk request, and set request. So these messages are from the manager, right? So this command generator is used to generate all these messages from the manager. So this command generator will generate the messages and it is gonna be reaching the command responder. So you have an example here. So this send PDU we saw, right? So this send PDU is being generated from the command generator. So it passes on to the dispatcher, and then you have this message processing model which identifies what kind of message, that is which version of the SNMP message it is, and you have the security model. So the security model does all the access control, and then it is coming back transferred on to the response. So this response is given to the manager from the agent, because through the network only. So this is happening in the agent side and this is happening in the manager side. So your manager is giving some message request, so that is going to reach the network, through the network it is going to reach the agent. So agent has got a similar thing, so that response, whatever you get it, so it is coming back and it is received by the manager. So you get the PDU handle. So this is how messages are passed in your SNMP version 3. So with the help of command generator application. So as I told you, command generator will generate messages. So here it is just an example. The messages can be anything like get request, get next request, anything. So here it is send PDU, so it is getting done, it is getting sent to the dispatcher. So dispatcher will pass it on to the processing model. So then security features are getting checked on, then it goes into the network. Through the network, it is going into the agent. So whatever request has been coming from the manager, that is processed by the agent and it is giving a response. So whatever response it is getting, so then it is transferred on to the manager here. So in kind of the message that responses is just a handle. So this is one example for command generator application. So next is command responder. So responder will respond to the message that it is being generated by the manager. So the messages, as I told you, get request, set request, all those things. So it performs the appropriate actions such that the response from the agent is given back to the manager. So that is done by the command responder. So it will respond to the messages that are being sent by the agent. So when a message is sent by the manager, it has to be transferred on the network to the agent. So you get some response from the agent. Either you will get the expected response or you will get an error message. Okay, so the error, what kind of errors you can have, that we saw earlier, right? Too big, authentication failure, all those things, all those kinds of errors. So you can either get a proper response from the agent or it can be just a error message. So that is processed by the command responder. So this command responder will give you the response for the messages that are being generated by your manager. So next one is notification originator. So this notification originator is used for the notification messages that comes from the agent. So the notification messages can be like your trap or inform message, any kind of message like authentication. For example, if your threshold is exceeding, okay, maximum threshold has exceeded, if the link is up, if the link is down, some kind of notification. So this notification originator will generate all kinds of notifications that the agent is supposed to give. So this will have to find that is, you will have to find a responder for this notification also. So if you are generating some kind of notification, then this has to be given to the manager. So that is done by the notification receiver. So it will find out where to send the message and what SNMP version and the security parameters to use. So this we saw already, right? So every message that we pass, it will be passed on to the dispatcher. Then it is passed on to the message processing subsystem. Then it is passed on to the security model. So that security model will check for the access control of the message that it is getting generated. So next is notification receiver. So this notification receiver will receive the notification messages that is generated by the agent. Okay, so these messages will have to be responded. So just like how we have the command responder, so we, that is done, the same thing is done by the notification receiver. So your notification receiver will do the processing such that the trap message or any kind of notification messages is reached to the manager. So that's your notification receiver. And the last one is proxy forwarder. So we have already seen what is a proxy server, right? So it will forward, it will make sure that all the version 1, version 2 messages are being executed on the version 3. So if it is a message which gets compatible with all the version, then it just passes through. If it is a non-SNMP message or if it is any advanced version, that is version 3 message, then it will concatenate the features which are added. So in get bulk request, we have this two components which are added. to the inform get request get next request message, that is maximum repetitions that is possible, and the number of non-repeating parameters we have. So these two parameters are initialized to zero, and then this these two parameters are appended to the get next response, so that it becomes your get bulk request. So it is get bulk request same as get next request message. So if you add a few parameters, then it is compatible with all the versions. So that is done by the proxy. So if it is a non-SNMP object, so that also it is capable of transferring or communicating onto the network. So the proxy forwarder handles four types of messages. So first, messages that are generated by the command generator, the command responder, notification generator, and those that contain a report indicator. So every kind of message that we pass on to the SNMP, it is going to the dispatcher. From the dispatcher, it is going into the processing unit, that is message processing subsystem, then on to the security features. So all kinds of messages that are being transferred they are able to cope up with the proxy. So the proxy is capable to cope up all the messages that are generated by the command generator, command responder, notification generator, and any kind of error report indicator. So that is it for today. So today we saw what are the different features we had in version 3. So the features that we have in version 3 is that we have this dispatching unit, and then we have this message processing unit, and then we have the security feature, and then we have this access control mechanism. So that is the enhancement that we have in version 3. Then we saw the architecture. So SNMP architecture, we have this SNMP engine and applications. So SNMP engine consists of dispatcher, message processing subsystem, and then we have security model, then message, that is access control subsystem. So all these four components are clubbed, and we call them as SNMP engine. And every that is SNMP engine is identified by the object identifier SNMP engine ID. So then we have seen five types of application modules: command generator module, command responder module, notification generator model, and the notification receiver model, and then your proxy. So that's it for today. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, then if you don't have any doubt,